जीईआरडी मैनेजमेंट गाइडलाइन। The primary treatment goals for gastroesophageal reflux disease are relief of symptoms, prevention of symptom relapse, healing of erosive esophagitis and prevention of complications of esophagitis. Lifestyle modifications include losing weight, avoiding acidic food, and avoiding to lie down after meals. In addition, medication history should be evaluated. Pharmacological management is initiated with full-dose proton pump inhibitor for 4 or 8 weeks. PPIs are most effective medical therapy for GERD due to their profound and consistent acid suppression. Patients with refractory GERD should receive PPI optimization. Partial responders can receive add-on therapy. There are many options for add-on therapies as listed here. Alginate and acid combination helps relieve episodic and postprandial reflux symptoms. Alginates displace the acid pocket by forming a gel-like barrier that pushes acidic compounds away from the esophagogastric junction, whereas the antacid portion neutralizes the gastric acid. Histamine to receptor antagonist therapy is provided for short-term to medium-term use. These have a more prolonged action than antacids and are recommended for nocturnal acid breakthroughs. Prokinetics enhance esophageal clearance of refluxate by accelerating gastric emptying. Bile acid sequestrants may be useful in curbing esophageal damage. If patient remains refractory to PPI plus add-on therapy, consider alternatives such as pain modulators and anti-reflux surgery. Antidepressants are presumed to have visceral analgesic properties. Start with a low dose of antidepressant at night before bed and build up the dose slowly. Anti-reflux surgery such as fund application is useful in large hiatal hernia causing volume-related reflux symptoms, in cases with evidence of aspiration or cardiac dysfunction, or in non-compliance. Fundoplication may help treat side effects associated with medical therapy, refractory esophagitis and refractory GERD. Laparoscopic fundoplication is associated with superior outcomes as compared to the open one. Attempt to stop or lower dosage if patient has good response to PPI treatment. PPI treatment at the lowest dose tolerated should be continued in esophagitis or Barrett esophagus. Urgent endoscopy is recommended in treatment failure or appearance of alarming symptoms. If no response to PPI, perform esophageal manometry and upper GI endoscopy to assess esophageal motor disorders and lower esophageal sphincter function.